Good morning all, camelbacktrading.org. Coming to you this Thursday morning, June 24th, we are looking at Window Traders market profile of SPY, IWM, and Triple Q. And as you can see right now, after making a new all-time high yesterday, the Triple Qs now have an overnight all-time high once again, as they've traded just below the 350 level at 349.96. As far as Russell, they're also attempting to gap higher. And SPY and ES, remember, they went out with a price probe to the downside yesterday, firmly being rejected. 13-wide POC that was an upside destination, now with 75 minutes to go, looks like it's going to be a downside destination as we look to gap higher. So ES would be gapping to all-time highs if they're able to sustain this or get close to it. Again, they'll be making all-time highs in the regular trade now, as they'll still be missing their overnight all-time high. Remember, we said we're going to treat yesterday as an inside day. Well, right now, we're looking to come out of it on a gap. The key is to start getting acceptance above these previous week highs and start a new leg higher. Destinations right now on the upside. We'll still use yesterday. Well, right now, the price probe being firmly rejected. The 13-wide POC will become a downside destination. I'll still use yesterday's high for now, 424.05. 424.87 daily high. 425.46 monthly high, all-time high. And that is exactly our overnight high right now. And then 426.21 pre-market all-time high from June 15th. On the downside, if we gap higher, 424.05, which is yesterday's high, then we have 423.37, the 13-wide POC. So any failure on this gap and acceptance into yesterday, we should go and trade there. Then we don't have anything until 422.51, yesterday's low, 422.42. which is our overnight low, 422.13 afternoon pullback low from the 22nd, and then the three sets of single prints that still remain that you should have also from the 22nd. So game plan for this morning. Well, if you're trading right now, or even if it's going to be at 9:30, if we are getting a gap of basically less than a dollar. Now, again, ES is going to be different because the closer you get to your pre-market all-time high, we'll see if they're going to front run that. But for SPY right now, we have a gap of about 70 somewhat cents. Not a bad gap to take a call play against, as they're looking to get to that other previous day's high. So from this level on down, I would look to take a call play out if the gap fills. If in the next 75 minutes or pre-market this gap gets any bigger, then I would wait to see if we get any sort of inventory adjustment at all. Remember, there's been absolutely no liquidation breaks in this market now for 3 days. Pretty incredible. No real short play at this time. There just isn't one. You're going to be opening on a gap, higher value, as SPY attempts to capture this daily high, the upper distribution from the 16th, and then their all-time high. Remember, they're lagging the ES because of the dividend. Right now, pre-market volume, only 275,000. So, again, not a lot on the tape just yet. It would be nice if they are going to attempt to start a new leg higher above these previous weekly highs with stronger volume. And then on the chart, we'll show you the weekly and the daily. So, again, here's the weekly. Right now, it's an inside week for SPY. So with 2 days to go, we'll see if they can take out last week's high. More importantly, though, if they do make all-time highs, is to get distance away from this four-week balance or five-week balance. Outside week down so far has been an absolute failure for the sellers. And then on the daily, right now they're going to be attempting to gap higher, start one-time framing up for the fourth day in a row. Again, markets don't go bull bear. They came into balance on the weekly, but right now the sellers have absolutely failed attempting to take the weekly from balance to down. Good luck trading today. Have a great day, and we'll recap at 4 p.m.